first of all, I mean, congratulations, I really enjoyed it. But you know,
I love that everybody's seen it.
You love that everybody what?
Has seen it.
Yeah, but, cool. But the, I mean, the first reaction, you know, when you think of this is, you know, it's been done, so what? How did you get past that kind of dreaded remake stigma and sort of go ahead and do something new with it?
Guys, can't concentrate on Craig's answer. Go. Go. Hair director.
You know what? I didn't even address that. It's like, for me, it just started with the script. I read Mighty Noxon's script, and it was so well fleshed out with the horror and the humor that I just saw the movie on the page. It wasn't too much later that I went back and looked at the original, just to make sure that we could pay homage to it where we needed to.
Well, I loved the original, and I was scared about and dubious about the notion of them remaking it, and then scared about the idea of attaching myself to it, and not scared that it kept me up at night, but just, oh God, I could see the judgment coming around the corner, because I kind of prejudged it already before I even read it. But then when I read it, I really liked it, and I had done a stretch of films that were kind of more darker and in emotional and psychological content, I suppose, or weighty, or at least existed in the real world. And I just wanted to have a bit of fun. When I read this, it was perfect, and then I met this fella and we spoke about it. But I loved the original, and I was kind of, yeah, I still am. I mean, I don't know, you would hope the fans of the, I've met a couple of fans that liked it, which is the coolest thing you can hear. Seriously, fans of the original think we didn't. You didn't fuck it up. Even that, it's like, you know, it's not like you're even, the bar is set that high. Yeah. It's straight, you know.
I think I talked to you a couple of years ago and you were talking at that point about having done 5 films in a row that were about guilt, basically.
Yeah,
this is a
lot.
Character completely without guilt, it seems to me.
Exactly. Yeah, it really is. Really is. And a character who acts without compunction, has no human traits at all. No remorse, no guilt, no compassion, no desire to find his romantic counterpart like Dracula did, and you know, and then in coming across Madame Mina, none of that. And that was kind of liberating in itself, because I have, and there's been a string of guys who are dealing heavily with their past, you know, we'll put it down to national origin.
Absolutely,
just being a human, just being a human.
And how about getting the like the look of it, you know, a new and a scary vampire? I mean, there have been so many vampire stories. How do you come up with a new take on the monster and getting him, you know, right?
KMB did the effects for this, and you know, they've done some amazing work over the years. And we had the original in terms of as a reference, because they're so iconic, like Amy's Mouth in the original. And in terms of vampire films, I don't think there's any other films that really have been that extreme. And we wanted to pay homage to that. So that was a really great starting point. And you know, for Colin, he's got like 5 stages that he goes through.
And how was the working with all that makeup? Was it a bit?
It was cool. It was fun. You get a bit tired of being painted white every day, but you know, over 400 years, he didn't get much sun, our Jerry.
So,
but the other stuff, the prosthetic stuff and the fangs, it was loads of fun. Like it really did. It kind of, you know, it defies you to not connect with your childish notion of a monster as well, and really kind of have that in there somewhere, you know, have it maybe a little bit more contained or structured, but certainly have it in there somewhere. It really was, going to work every day, it was just a blast, you know.
And finally, how many buckets of blood did you get through overall, do you think?
It was a pretty good few. I mean,
there was a lot of
blood. There was a good bit of blood, yeah. One stage you had a super soaker and
yeah, there was a bit of hosing going on.
Silly.
All right, thank you.